Blue Origin just cancelled New Glenn launch. What happened? Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. On January 9th, 2025, Blue Origin announced the postponement of its highly anticipated first launch of the New Glenn rocket. Originally slated for 1 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, on Friday, January 10th, the launch was rescheduled to Sunday, January 12th, at the same time due to adverse weather conditions in the Atlantic Ocean, where the rocket's booster was intended to land. This mission marks the debut of Blue Origin's ambitions to challenge the likes of SpaceX in the reusable rocket domain. The delay underscores the critical nature of the booster's recovery, a testament to the company's commitment to reusability, which is central to reducing the cost of space travel and missions. The decision to delay was prompted by what Blue Origin described as a high sea state in the Atlantic, where the first stage of New Glenn was to be recovered on a barge named Jacqueline after Jeff Bezos's mother. The company's statement on the social media platform X highlighted the ambitious nature of their recovery plan, noting, "We know landing the booster on our first try offshore in the Atlantic is ambitious, but we're going for it. You know, I saw some of you commenting 2 days ago that Blue Origin would scrub the New Glenn launch on the actual day. And yes, they turned out to be right. While it's true that New Glenn is behind schedule, let's try to stay positive and support Blue Origin during this critical time. They're really optimistic about this rocket, aiming for reusability on a scale that could genuinely contribute to the already growing space sector." Also, some folks did ask why they can't launch like SpaceX's Starship test flights. Well, what you all have to understand is that SpaceX and Blue Origin operate with two very different philosophies. One, SpaceX is like the throw everything at the wall and see what sticks type of strategy, with Elon Musk famously saying, "Failure is an option here. If things are not failing, you are not innovating enough." They've got this hardware-rich approach where they can afford to learn from failures in real time because they've got a series of hardware ready to go up next. On the other hand, Blue Origin takes a more measured, slow and steady wins the race approach. They're more about ensuring each piece of tech is as close to perfect as possible before launch. It's not about how fast you can get something off the ground, but how reliably you can do it over and over again. Yes, it might mean they're not churning out launches like SpaceX, but when they do get it right, it could mean less risk, more efficiency, and potentially a game changer in terms of cost effectiveness. So, do you all think Blue Origin can succeed on their first ever New Glenn launch attempt? Share your thoughts in the comments below. Reusability has become a buzzword in the space industry, with SpaceX leading the charge by successfully recovering and reusing the first stages of its Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets. Blue Origin aims to follow suit, with each New Glenn first stage designed for at least 25 flights. This approach not only aims at economic efficiency, but also environmental sustainability by reducing the need to manufacture new rockets for each launch. The New Glenn rocket's maiden voyage carries more than just the weight of a booster landing. It also involves the Blue Ring Pathfinder, a testbed for future Blue Origin satellite buses, spacecraft, or even commercial space stations. The success or failure of this mission could significantly impact Blue Origin's 2025 objectives, including launching Lunar Lander Pathfinder missions, satellites for NASA's Mars missions, and the first batch of Amazon's Kuiper Internet satellites. First launches, however, are notoriously challenging. The complexity of a rocket's inaugural flight means there's a higher risk of failure due to untested conditions in space. Unlike SpaceX, which has adopted a hardware-rich approach, allowing for iterative learning through potential failures, Blue Origin faces a different kind of pressure. While they can accept a landing failure, there's an underlying need for the mission to succeed, at least in part for certification by the US Space Force. If New Glenn performs well, Blue Origin could accelerate its roadmap, potentially advancing projects like the Blue Moon Lunar Lander for NASA's Artemis program and the Escapade mission to Mars. However, should the mission encounter significant issues, delays could push back these projects by a year or more, impacting not only Blue Origin's timeline, but also the NASA's broader space exploration goals. The new launch window, when it opens on Sunday, will extend from 1 a.m. to 4 a.m. Eastern Time, offering a three-hour period for the attempt. If conditions do not permit a launch on January 12th, Blue Origin has the flexibility to attempt another launch through January 16th, as indicated by a notice to airmen from the FAA. This launch is not just a test of technology, but also of Blue Origin's capability to serve as a robust competitor in the growing space industry. With contracts already lined up for future missions, including those for national security and commercial purposes, the performance of New Glenn could solidify or challenge Blue Origin's position in the market, particularly against established players like SpaceX and the United Launch Alliance, ULA. As the countdown to Sunday's launch continues, all eyes will be on Cape Canaveral, watching not just for a successful liftoff, but for what this first flight means for the future of space exploration and commercial space travel. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. You know, we're on a mission to reach 65,000 subscribers by next week. Join us on this journey, and let's see if we can make it happen together. The preparations for the first human moon mission in over 50 years are well underway. The Artemis II mission, part of NASA's Artemis program, is taking shape with the assembly of the Space Launch System SLS rocket at Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Boeing, the main contractor for SLS, is overseeing the construction where the rocket's solid rocket boosters have begun to be stacked. These boosters, critical for the mission, arrived in segments from Northrop Grumman's facility in Utah back in September 2023. They've been processed in Florida, with the initial assembly occurring in the Vehicle Assembly Building, VAB, where the first segment, the left aft assembly, was hoisted onto a mobile launcher. The twin solid rocket boosters, towering at 177 feet each, will provide more than 75% of the thrust needed for the SLS to break free from Earth's gravity at launch. These boosters are made up of five segments each, engineered to support the entire 322-foot SLS structure, including the Orion spacecraft, during the final assembly phase. Parallel to this, the Orion spacecraft, which will carry the Artemis II crew, has been undergoing tests, including exposure to space-like conditions in an altitude chamber in November to ensure it can handle the harsh environment of space travel. Artemis II is a crucial step in NASA's broader Artemis program, aimed at returning humans to the lunar surface by the end of this decade. This mission follows the uncrewed Artemis 1, which successfully orbited the Moon in 2022. The next mission, Artemis 3, is planned for 2026 and will see astronauts land on the Moon for the first time since Apollo 17 in 2026, 1972. The Artemis II crew includes NASA Commander Reid Wiseman, NASA pilot Victor Glover, who will be the first black astronaut to venture beyond low Earth orbit, NASA mission specialist Christina Koch, set to be the first woman to do so, and Canadian astronaut Jeremy Hansen, marking the first non-American on such a mission. Announced in April 2023, their launch was initially planned for December 2024, but has been postponed to 2025 due to engineering challenges, especially with the Orion's heat shield. Both Artemis II and the subsequent Artemis III missions are developmental, focusing on safety and learning, which means timelines are flexible and subject to change as new information and technology developments dictate. The crew for Artemis III has yet to be named. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.